हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू आर डूइंग ग्रेट एट वेरियस एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ योर लाइव्स। फर्स्ट टाइम ऑथर दीपक कृपाल इज अ डॉक्टर बाय प्रोफेशन एंड राइटर बाय पैशन। वेल, दिस इज हिज फर्स्ट बुक प्रिंटेड, दैट्स व्हाई आई एम मेंशनिंग दैट ही इज अ फर्स्ट टाइम ऑथर, और अदरवाइज ही इज अ नॉन फिगर इन ऑनलाइन ब्लॉगिंग कम्युनिटी ऑफ इंडिया इन लिटररी निश ऑफ कोर्स, where he mainly shares his poems and poetries. Here are our personal views about his first book, The Devil's Gate, An Impossible Journey, Part 1. The book is published by Lit Start Publishing Private Limited in 2013. Being the gateway to the fictional world explored within, the book cover plays a very important role in making the first impression of a book, and that is more often than not is responsible to catch a browser's attention. So let us take a look at the cover page of the book. Devil's Gate is a fictional place, of course, and the cover designer came up with showing a gate-like illustration surrounded by ghoul creatures. You can also find some monuments at far distance. Overall, an imaginative cover design. However, the black and white colors used in the cover page may not get attention of many browsers. Possibly to compensate that, the title is written in the red color. A moderately good cover page, which could have been better. The book takes you to a very different panorama, which most of the books from modern Indian writers keep away themselves from. Various dialogues and descriptions in the book clearly shows the author's affection towards the nature in a whole. It includes his love for environment and animals too. The author seems to have studied some of the basic Indian ancient literature as well. It would not be wrong to say that you will find the traces of some works by J.R.R. Tolkien, C.S. Lewis, J.K. Rowling, Dan Brown, and others in a different manner in this book. Of course, a writer is having his own favorites, but it doesn't make him a copycat of the other. We must say the influences may be there, and it is always in all the creations. But writer came up with his original writing style in this book. At the very beginning of the book, you will find some very lengthy sentences. Sometimes the entire paragraph is written in a single sentence, and too much uses of comma there. It also takes a little while to set up the story, but once it is set up, it is almost a flawless journey till the middle of the book. The first segment of the second half is a little less fluent, but last few pages of the climax sets the tempo again. The book is definitely a very good thriller. When I started reading the book, I was wondering why a cat and a dog is chosen as the protagonists. But the questions are also answered in the second half of the book. The author has wisely decided to go for easy to remember names for most of the characters, like Katy the cat, Doug the dog, Billy the bird, Chiku the child demon, Shardul the lion, and so on. The book indirectly explores the problems the nature faces due to some of the human behavior. It includes cutting up jungles in order to acquire land to build and develop cities. The book at various places talk about some side effects and even main effects of the power-hungry people and the results of their unwise decision that take a toll over the nature. The author's vision seems to be crystal clear about the story in his mind. In fact, the Devil's Gate is the first mentioned after around half of the book is complete. Let me quote some of the gems of writing from the book so you get a fair idea about the quality of writing you can expect from the book. Bravery without sword is like slavery without lord. There is nothing bad in being optimistic, as long as don't lose the touch with reality. Do I enjoy the luxury of an option? Playing with danger is a child's play. A real game starts when the danger starts playing with you. If you want to do something bigger, then you will have to think beyond the survival instinct. You don't have to be a lion to put a lion hard effort. Tragedy of yesterday is the joke of tomorrow. Kindness is the cover used by faint-hearted to conceal cowardice. Oh, I hate love. It weakens you. I am not God because I am powerful. It is because of my kindness that I am God. Even the smallest creature can cause your downfall if you are driven by power and arrogance rather than by your mind and heart. Courage is not about removing your fears. It is about accepting the damage you are ready to bear while you take fight to your fears. Of course, there are places where long descriptions make the things a little boring, especially in the second half, but overall, it all relies on tight writing. Mostly, when we talk about human heroes, we talk about some larger-than-the-life figures. Same way, when we talk about animals, we mention lion, tiger, and other not-so-ordinary animals in a way that they can do some heroic work. In those terms, the book explores some ordinary animals' heroic works. It is certainly after a long time we are having ordinary animals and their tale. The book is not anti-human though. Animals seems to hate some stuff about the mankind, but they are fond of and takes note of some genius abilities of mankind as well. We will not reveal the story as it will make your reading experience less interesting due to lack of surprise element, but we can say this: it is the story of ordinary animals who are assigned a mission to find out the invisible island. It is known as the Island of 500 Graves and is visible for a while in the full moon night. They need to meet the master of the same and negotiate with him the possibility to let the animals set up their living there. They need to take the step because most of their villages and jungles are destroyed by mankind in order to set up and develop cities there. The island is full of demons who are in hunger and thirst for flesh of the bodies. Can a deal with them possible to make out? The adventurous journey is the rest of the story. Interestingly, there is a book trailer also launched along with, but the trailer is not that appealing. If it is made like Harry Potter movie trailer with a high budget, of course, it would definitely attract more readers. The confidence of the writer is also must to mention. The book name itself suggests that the author is not only confident about the commercial success of the book, but he also had a well-thought long story, and his book is a part of chronicles he is intended to explore via his pen. The last two pages confirm that the story doesn't end here. It seems the solved one is just a part of the problem. The main problem still hangs on the head. Yes, we are talking about the next part or sequel of the book for sure. So, what is the conclusion? Well, overall, a nice and gripping thriller. The book is appealing for the children as well. It would be interesting to see the response by children. Maybe the book requires better marketing and awareness about it. It may be an Indian answer to popular kids' literature like Chronicles of Narnia, The Hobbit, Harry Potter series, and more. And that doesn't mean that adults will not like the book. It is interesting for the readers of all age group, as far as my opinion is concerned. So, Have you already read the book? Are you planning to read it? What do you think about this book review? Do you find it helpful in deciding whether to go for the book or not? Please do share your genuine remarks via comments below. If you have enjoyed listening to the review, please hit the like button. And do not forget to share it with your friends and other fellows whom you think such reviews interest more. Till we meet with our next podcast, bye bye, take care, namaskar.